Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining me for another video. If you're new to my channel, my name is Stephanie. I am a life and relationship coach. So let's get into this week's topic. I love this because some people see this and some people don't. We're gonna talk about narcissism and we're gonna really talk about why, and not just narcissists, even someone who's really toxic and unhealthy can do this as well. We're gonna talk about mirroring, or why do people copy other people, essentially. But before we do get into this week's video, if you have not subscribed, don't forget to click on the subscribe button down below. We have just hit 400,000 subscribers, which is so crazy. Thank you guys so much for all of your love and support. I love what I do and I love that you guys love these videos. So definitely also comment down below with any topics that you would like me to do on this channel. And yeah, that's about it. So let's get into this week's video. So mirroring. So when we are kids and we're growing up, you'll see this in children, you'll see it in babies. And mirroring is basically where the child will emulate the parent, obviously, right? They're copying each other. So when we're a baby, you might see things like the parent looking at the child and kind of clapping, and then the child starts to clap. And then the child will see the parent smile because the child's mirroring what the parent's doing. And so in that moment of the child acknowledging, okay, mom's smiling at me or dad's laughing at me, there's that aspect of being seen. And you will hear this from time to time, especially on this channel, about being able to have been seen when you were a child. That is a huge, huge part of self-development, because that means that I matter, that you see me, even though I'm doing what you're doing, you still acknowledge that I'm here. And so it's a huge part of self-development. When someone who didn't get that, not just necessarily mom and dad clapping in front of you, but when they weren't able to be seen, they're going to grow up to not have a true sense of self. So as I'm a child, if I am seen with examples of, okay, yes, the clapping, but also being seen by you listening to me, you validating me, you giving me choices, you giving me options. And of course, we're not gonna give choices and options to kids throughout, you know, the time they're born to whatever time they decide to become an adult and move out. But we're not gonna always say, yes, the choice is in your hands, the choice is in your hands. There are going to be times where the child, there is no choice. This is what we have to go and do. Because if you do too much of the choices and giving of options, then you're kind of raising essentially a narcissist in a way, because you're enabling that what we need to do is leave, but you don't want to leave. Okay, we won't leave. And that's not really how life works. So with parenting, it was all about balance, of finding the balance of being able to validate, to have your child be seen and heard, to give them choices. And the reason why this is so important is because then that child will grow up to have what's called a sense of self. And you might have heard that time and time again before. If you are diving into self-development or narcissism, you will have 100% heard that phrase. So if I have a good sense of self, that means that on some level, someone has mirrored that back to me. On some levels, I have been seen, I have been heard, someone has allowed me to have choices where I actually get to make up my own mind, which means I'm connected to myself to know, okay, I would like peas and not carrots for dinner. So the more and more that I was able to get all of those things growing up, then I grew up to be an adult who has a really good sense of my own self. I know who I am, I know what I like, I know what I feel, and I'm accepted for who I am and what I think and what I feel. Another huge part of self-development or raising a healthy person. Now, obviously, with someone who's narcissistic, the reason why this person has a personality disorder, the reason why someone could be toxic and unhealthy from the get-go, quite frankly, the reason why someone could be severely codependent is because they lacked most of those things. Maybe they got a few of those things, but they didn't get them enough, they didn't get them consistently in order to really form that healthy sense of who I am. So remember, if I'm codependent, I probably got on some levels a lot of the neglect that someone who's narcissistic got. But what I did was I took that abuse or that neglect and I went in a different direction. So instead of kind of like shutting myself down and killing off that part of myself where now I basically have this representative that's always living life for me, hence narcissism. What I do now is I walk on eggshells around people. I'm hyper focused on the outside and everyone else, and I have no idea who I am. I have no idea what I think and what I feel, because all I want to do is make everyone happy, because I grew up in environments where I walked on eggshells. And if I was relaxed, if I did what mom said, if I didn't talk to dad, if I did this, then everything was cool. But if I didn't, then I received abuse or I received neglect. And so the child learned over time to basically behave in a certain way in the world in order to keep the peace, essentially. Someone who's narcissistic, again, same treatment, but unfortunately what they did is they just basically killed off that sense of self where they don't have that connection. They will never probably be able to have that connection really with themselves in that way, because now they have a personality disorder that is, chances are, really, really hard to heal. That now I operate in the world not really knowing who I am. So while someone who's codependent probably doesn't really know who they are either, they still have an ability to tap into that sense of self if they really work that muscle and learn how to heal from codependency. Someone who's a narcissist or has a really, you know, personality disorder, is really, really toxic and unhealthy, they can't do that. So the reason why someone will mirror other people or copy or just kind of basically play a fake character, essentially, is because they have absolutely no idea who they are. Now, you might have done this from time to time. I'm sure there are times where perhaps if you don't have a good sense of your own self, that you saw something or heard something and then you started kind of mirroring it. It's really the same thing that we're talking about, but when we're talking about someone who's narcissistic, they do it in all areas of their life, not just in like one area at one point. Because if you're a normal, healthy person, you might mirror people here and there, but then you'll recognize, number one, that you're doing it, and number two, you'll stop it, because you'll go, well, wait a minute, well, who am I? And do I want to behave in this way? Or do I want to think this? Or do I want to do this? You'll be self-aware to know that you are doing it. Someone who's narcissistic has absolutely no idea that they're doing it, because they're just trying to grab onto things to create characters in order to operate in the world. So because they don't really have an identity, they don't really know who they are, they don't really have a sense of their own selves, they're constantly looking at outside people to see kind of like what's acceptable. Okay, so if my friend Joe did this and he got a couple laughs out of it, okay, maybe I'll do that next time. Or maybe I'll do it, quite frankly, in the next 5 minutes, I'll do the same thing. Or, you know, put my own little kind of twist on it or spin on it. So they're going to constantly take things from other people and make their own person, essentially. And they're always taking the things that they can see people really love about that person. Their whole life is about what do people think. They care very, very much about image. They care very, very much about, will someone like me? Will I get love? Will I get admiration? Because again, they are extremely insecure. And so if I'm very insecure, if I don't know who I am or what I'm about, then I have to fit a mold. I have to be like everyone else. I have to fit in. And so they're going to always conform and copy and mirror what other people are doing because they don't know who they are. So another reason why a narcissist will mirror you, for example, and not just someone else in the outside, is because the more they mirror you, the more you look like soulmates, the more you look like that twin flame, the more you will essentially fall in love with this person, because this person is just like you, right? And that's what we're always looking for, is for someone that's kind of like me. And so if they show you something that's very, very different, you may not like that. So if I'm showing you, then of course you're going to love me because I'm behaving just like you do. So the problem with this, and this is kind of where these people tend to get into trouble, is they're never sticking to one thing. They're always adapting to whoever the audience is. So whoever's in their life, whoever the new supply is, whoever's around them, they're going to always conform to that audience to be that character. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and comment down below on any topics you would like me to do in the future. And I will see you next time.